Shay has been on the Gold Coast for a long time, haven't you?
Born and raised, my love.
Born and raised on the beautiful Goldie. And she ran, look, if you want someone who has some political nous, Shay ran for
IMOP.
Who knows what IMOP is? Well, not everyone. Informed Medical Options Party. So they ran in the election last year.
Oh, that's where you're from.
So she's not a retiring flower here. She's been on the Goldie for a long time. Businesswoman of the Year in 1993. Her dad was a well-known local Miami businessman. So yeah. She's from the hood. And she has immersed herself in natural therapies industry. That's her passion, is all about helping us defend our bodies with natural therapies. She's always opposed government overreach into personal liberties, which I think is what we're all about. The overreach now is absolutely ridiculous, as I'm sure you all know, and really believes in the right for us all to be informed about the options that are available to us so that we can make a medical choice without coercion or financial penalty. I think I'll wrap it up there. Shay, please welcome to the stage.
Hey guys, thanks. All right, I went to Miami High School. I remember it before it had the High Miami High sign up there. I remember that. And my dad had the old Golden Fleece. Anybody old enough to remember the Golden Fleece service station?
Yes.
Yeah, he had the Golden Fleece, and across the road he had the Caltex. Here, and they've both become car yards since then. So, a lot of people remember my dad, Jeff, and he had Gold Spa, which was the only Australian-owned vitamin company apart from Blackmores. Which Blackmores, does most people know that Monsanto bought Blackmores? Yeah, so be very careful with Blackmores products. Yeah, so, but that Gold Spa's still going, but it's not with my father anymore. Dad's well and truly retired. My dad is 90 this year and still looks 55. So he lives his philosophy, and his philosophy has always been have a healthy, balanced diet, eat half food, half junk. he's going great. So, beautiful David mentioned before, you might have seen me on that TV show, The One. I am a well-known psychic as well, which really rattled a few people in the IMOP party. They were like, we were going to damage our credibility. Not when you realise that, who knows Ray Thorpe, Happy High Herbs?
Yeah.
Happy Herbs, Happy Healthy Herbs shops.
Yeah.
Ray's a dear, dear friend of mine. In 1996, they brought out a law, they passed a law on Christmas Eve, saying all products that say they are natural are banned.
Wow.
Right? And they arrested Ray, and they arrested a lady who produced Wild Yam Cream. Well, myself and the gentleman from Bionic Products, he funded it. We got a petition around, got 1 million signatures, got that reversed very quickly within 3 months. So, but we've had wins and wins and wins. So since 1990, I think it was 96, I think that happened. Can't remember the exact year. But I've seen this coming, the situation that we're in since then. And how did I know this was coming? You can all tell, because all you've got to do is watch the cycles, look at the history. What this present cycle that we're going through with these vaccines, it's been brewing since September 11. This is not about the virus. The virus we're dealing with now is fear. Fear is the virus. And unfortunately, it's not just the government with the official mainstream media line that they're putting out. You know the government is also putting out anti-sentiment so that they can make us run in this direction like lemmings and run in that direction like lemmings and get us fighting amongst ourselves, get us confused and exhausted, which is where they want us to be. All right. So what we have to do is take a step back from the fear, right? Because you saw them use the fear in September 11, right? You saw them. That was the first time they really used the fear. They're using the fear again now. Do not be afraid of these people. They're friggin' idiots. Don't overestimate their intelligence. Please don't. Right? Because I have a letter framed at home from Therapeutic Goods Association. It says, "Oh, Dr. DeMonte, we are very, very sorry. You've obviously misunderstood what we are trying to do here. And please understand we are repealing this law, right? And that we will be putting in a review board." And I put out a mass media campaign at that stage in 1996 and said, "Watch these bastards through the back door. We've won the battle, but it's not over yet." I'm sure they thought Dr. de Montfort was somebody, a little gentleman in France somewhere with a French horn-rimmed glasses. They didn't know, it's just a blonde laying on the beach on Gold Coast somewhere. But we can have a win, but we cannot fight on every frontier. Can you see how they're trying to get us to fight on every front? Use up our money, use up our time. What we spend mostly is our time. We give things value. Time, effort, and energy is more valuable to me than money, and I'm sure it's more valuable to you as well. So, coordinated efforts, but the old maxim, you've got to be the change that you want to see in the world, is the most important thing. The lady from the community group, the orange pieces of paper,
Reignite democracy.
Thank you very much. Because you said a lot what that I was going to say. Sorry. The miracle word, you saved me, I can focus on other things now. The miracle word that we have to remember is no. This is our mantra, right? No. They are asking for compliance. Asking, will you comply? Right. And if you want to not comply, you have to say, "No, David, I'm so sorry to hear about your daughter. Tell her to have a home birth. I know midwives in Sydney that will be there with her in a heartbeat." Yeah. But everything that they've said to her, she is, but don't even go there, because everything they've said to her, she just has to smile to them and go, "No." Now, one thing about being raised on the Gold, anybody who does know me from Miami High School might remember that I was raised a Jehovah's Witness. I'm not now, it's okay, you're safe. But being a Jehovah's Witness, like, we know how hard it is to get somebody to give you, to force you to do something medically you don't want to do. Everybody knows about the Jehovah's Witness no blood transfusion thing. Alright? They can't get you to do it. It takes them court orders in your specific case. Right? What they have asked your daughter to do is they're asking her for compliance. Not that she has to. See, she just has to say to them, "No." This is, tell them to say it's her religious belief. Because they shit themselves when you say that. Right? But just say, "No." Right? Christian scientists, Jehovah's Witness, anything. "No, my religious beliefs won't allow me to do that. You will do it this way. Otherwise, you're discriminating against me." Because this is discrimination, right? This is discrimination, right? And we have to learn just to say no. So I've seen the red light. Right, so I won't continue on, but just recognize we've seen these patterns before. The power is with you, right? Please make sure that you look at the bird flu, which was the last time they tried to run this exact play with the corona. It was a coronavirus, the bird flu, and it failed. And David is right, it is failing now. Britain, Germany, England, Sweden, France is going. I actually said that to Sierra Sue on the way over here, and she said, "Oh, France is already saying no." It is failing, right? Because people are saying no.
What about America?
Americans.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Wow.
very powerful woman. I so much appreciate that you're here tonight. Thank you so much for coming along. Obviously, if anyone would like to talk to Shay later on, then please feel free to pick her brain.
Rui nerei fia matrai, rui eisha e noa. Rui nerei fia matrai, rui eisha e noa.